Hello, I'm Donna Moore, CEO and Chairwoman of the LoRa Alliance, and I'm thrilled to be here today to talk about LoRaWAN, which is the best networking solution for smart agriculture. All right, let's begin. So the LoRa Alliance is a nonprofit global alliance. It was launched in 2015. LoRaWAN develops, maintains, and promotes the open LoRaWAN standard. We have three committees, a technical committee, a certification committee, and a marketing committee. And through these committees, we drive the standard forward for adoption, for continued development, and for market collaboration. You know, if you're a member of the LoRa Alliance, one of the key benefits that you get as a member is a LoRa Alliance, LoRaWAN certification test tool. And this test tool tests all devices against the LoRaWAN specification. And it's free to members, and it really helps you know that your device works as intended, which is key for the market. You know, the value of certification, whether you're deploying or developing LoRaWAN certified devices, is really around confidentiality, reliability. You know, it reduces support costs and prevents failures later. So I highly recommend, if you're listening to this webinar, that you look into LoRa Alliance and you look into becoming a LoRaWAN member and all the benefits that it will give you to help drive the LoRaWAN standard in China. So we have a huge membership base, and this membership base is critical because it allows choice, it allows growth, and it allows partnerships throughout the entire globe. And if you look at what's really required to drive end-to-end IoT solutions and to simplify the development and the deployment process, it requires member collaboration. So if you look at everything from the development of chipsets to devices to gateways to servers to operators to cloud platforms to solution providers and system integrators, they work together to help make the deployments easy and simple for the end customer, because it really does take a village to deploy IoT and deploy it correctly with the best breed and to make it easier for the end consumer. So if you look at all of the use cases, and I'm focusing on agriculture right now, you can see we've got livestock monitoring and crop production, soil health, farm asset management, irrigation control, and weather station management. And under each of these areas, there are multiple use cases that LoRaWAN can help in agriculture in China. And again, that's why this gigantic ecosystem that collaborates and partners and works together to drive these use cases. And it's how these companies are driving their business, getting a return on their investment, and a return for the customer's investment. Now, you know, it's not only agriculture. Once you have a LoRaWAN network up and running, you can expand that same network to energy and utilities, to cities, asset tracking, industrial IoT, building off automation. Retail is a huge one that's driving forward with LoRa Alliance, as well as healthcare. And certainly supply chain, fleet management, and LoRaWAN is driving even further into the connected home and community market. So that's why it is critical that you use LoRaWAN as an open standard, because open standards are the only way you can scale for massive IoT. You know, we know, and if you look at history, proprietary and single source connectivity solutions are not viable for scale. It really takes an ecosystem partnering and working together to develop and drive all those use cases I just pointed out. And you know, if you are using LoRaWAN, if you are using LoRa as a radio chip, but not the LoRaWAN standard, you are missing out on scale, on adding to your network, and all the benefits that LoRaWAN brings forward. So LoRa, the radio, and LoRaWAN, the standard, is the way to drive your business to scale in agriculture, and then to continue to scale in other verticals. Now, if you look at the benefits for smart agriculture, LoRaWAN is the perfect solution to drive all those use cases that I identified earlier in smart agriculture. So let's look at smart agricultural needs. You know, it really is about network location and flexibility. It is really easy to deploy a private LoRaWAN network, or it could be a network that is on a public network, or it could be a hybrid network. You know, LoRaWAN is very flexible in its deployment models. You know, next up, we look at financing, and that's really important to farms and different types of agricultural businesses. With LoRaWAN, and only with LoRaWAN, you can have a CapEx, so a capital X, where they buy the equipment and expense it out over time, or they can have an operating X, an OpEx. And an OpEx is where they buy the services on a monthly basis and put it on the P&L. So both of these models are flexible with LoRaWAN, and it really depends on the need of the customer. So next up is the data management and safety and precision for agriculture. And it's important to note that LoRaWAN is bidirectional in the security, and it protects the data that is going back and forth on the sensors. LoRaWAN was built with security in mind by the top security experts from all over the world. Now, next step that's very important for agriculture is long-term deployments and a high and immediate ROI. You know, LoRaWAN is very low cost to implement and deploy. It's got a 10 plus year battery life, which means you deploy the devices and you leave them for 10 plus years. You don't have to go out and manage them. You don't need to go out and change the batteries. And again, this is also why certification and testing on the LoRaWAN test tool is important, because you know before you deploy them that it's going to work as needed. And this is future-proofing as well. You know, we have over-the-air automatic updates and safety controls, important for agriculture. So the next piece is really about availability. And the availability with LoRaWAN and the penetration, which is unique specifically to LoRaWAN, is about its penetration. So it works in remote location. It covers vast distances. It penetrates soil. It penetrates underground. It penetrates through water tanks. LoRaWAN is the only LPWAN technology solutions that can go this distance, you know, 10 plus miles, cover this vast open space where there's no cellular coverage, as well as, again, the deep penetration, because many of the locations that you're going to need to put a sensors are buried or in metal containers or whatnot, depending on what you're tracking. And LoRaWAN goes through concrete and through all types of difficult situations. You know, and the ability to scale up, and I'm gonna talk about it a little bit more in the future, but as I noted, once you have a network up, you can add more and more use cases. And LoRaWAN being an open standard and LoRaWAN having so many members that are innovating new and exciting solutions for agriculture, you can continue to add those to your network because it's an open standard, because these members work together. So you're not locked into one use case. You can grow and grow and grow as innovation happens. And the more sensors you use, you do not need to add an additional network, because one gateway can cover tens of thousands of devices. So that's very exciting and very cost efficient for agriculture. And like I mentioned, last but not least, the choice of vendors. Because of our large ecosystem, you have a choice of vendors. You're not locked in one. If one's not working for you, you can switch vendors. You can switch devices. You can add new vendors. You can add new devices. You can negotiate on pricing because of the very large, vast ecosystem. And I'll tell you, it's how our members have really driven their business. By partnering together, the pie gets bigger, not smaller, because the number of use cases for LoRaWAN is really endless. So let's just look a little bit at the technology gap that LoRaWAN fills. If you look at Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, you know, they're really high bandwidth, which is great, but they're short range and they don't have the penetration or the distance like LoRaWAN has. If you look at cellular or 5G, it's really, cellular is really mostly used for critical services, video, voice, you know, it's high power, it's high bandwidth. That is not the area that LoRaWAN plays. So if you look at LoRaWAN, LoRaWAN is really around the 75% of the market that is massive IoT. The high bandwidth critical needs is about 25% of the IoT market, but the 75% that is low power, long distance, massive IoT, that's LoRaWAN space. And, you know, LoRaWAN works also though, it's not just about LoRaWAN. We really believe in multi-RAN strategies, and we have many, many use cases working with cellular, working with 5G, working with Bluetooth, working with Wi-Fi. If you go to our website, you'll see many, many use cases where we're working in partnership with the other technologies. And that's what makes this so exciting. Again, it is not one type of technology is going to fill this market. It really is about the needs of the use case. And it really is about working in partnership with other technologies to cover all the use cases. So I just want to make sure that it's clear for LoRaWAN. If you look at the device on the screen, LoRaWAN's devices are made up of Simtex PHY, which is the radio. And then LoRaWAN's open standard is the LoRaWAN link layer standard and the LoRaWAN regional parameters. That's what makes up the LoRaWAN standard. And on top of that, there are various application layers. Now you can see that once the device sends a signal to the gateway, to the network server, and all the way around to the applications server, again, LoRaWAN is the link layer and LoRaWAN is a back-end specification. So it's just important to note that, and I know in China, there are quite a few use cases that have LoRa, but not LoRaWAN. And so if you want to drive your market and you want to grow your market and you want the best of breed in terms of technology and distance and penetration, it's LoRa plus LoRaWAN. And that is how you will drive your business. That is how you will support agriculture in China. And that is how you will get your best return on investment. All right, I just wanted to make one quick note about coverage to show you that LoRaWAN is the de facto worldwide, and there's a reason why, because it's the best LPWAN standard out there. And if you look at the map, the yellow and the yellow-green is everywhere that all the countries that we have LoRaWAN. We have over 151 LoRaWAN public network operators, not counting private networks. And if the green and yellow combined together is where LoRaWAN has roaming capabilities, which are growing every single day. All right, so with that, I just wanted to say that if you would like to explore further use cases on agriculture, I really encourage you to visit the LoRaWAN website, and you'll see about agriculture and how agriculture and LoRaWAN is driving the best use cases to improve agriculture. And the link is right at the bottom. And finally on this, before I move forward, I'd like to talk about LoRaWAN driving IoT growth across China in all markets. This year, in fact, just a few months ago, we had an incredible webinar, and it was really about LoRaWAN in China specifically, and what are the updates and the plans for LoRaWAN in 2021 in China. So I highly recommend that you go to our website and review this incredible webinar specifically developed for China. Now with that, I'd like to turn the webinar over to Jane. Jane is with MileSight, and Jane is from China. MileSight is in China, and they have a great webinar and use case they'd like to share with you. So Jane, go ahead and take it away, thanks.
Hi, and thank you for having MileSight here. Donna just fill you in the LoRa Alliance and LoRaWAN, and I'm excited to give you an update on China's LoRaWAN industrial market. As one of the members of LoRa Alliance, over the past couple of years, We'll be working really hard on IoT areas, especially in the applications and deployments of LoRaWAN. And we have achieved some great results, and we did not do all this by ourselves. We deliver our products and services to users by working with our partners within LoRa Alliance. We believe in the community. The deeper we dive into, the better we could work mutually. So, with the dramatic rise and development of LoRa and LoRaWAN around the globe, LoRaWAN is showing good promise in China market. Actually, since 2013, many Chinese companies have developed various LoRaWAN-based hardware and software in several fields, laying the foundation of the whole LoRaWAN industrial marketplace. Since 2018, lots of Chinese giants have joined the LoRa Alliance, such as Alibaba, Tencent, Jingdong, China Tower, China Unicorn, etc. In fact, in the same year, a liaison agreement was established between the LoRa Alliance and IoT Connectivity Alliance. In 2019, a specific LoRaWAN regional parameters was released, unifying China's LoRaWAN regional standards to avoid the fragmentation of LoRaWAN in China. And since 2020, LoRaWAN has gradually integrated with other technologies such as 5G and AI, which leads to a trend of building an AIoT world. In LoRaWAN's case, overall, the entire market has maintained a trend of rapid growth, and we are expecting more in the near future. And the application of it evolved with time. In the early stages, LoRaWAN was popular in the applications which concentrated in meter reading, in terms of water, gas, and electricity. Then it spread to more diversified areas, such as fire smoke detection, smart city, smart agriculture, smart security, smart home, etc., forming thousands of landing cases. In fact, LoRaWAN is developing really quickly in China. The number of companies joining the LoRaWAN industry has noticeably increased year by year, which contributes to the overall improvement of industry ecology, covering a huge lineup of upstream, midstream, and downstream reaches, including manufacturers, system integrators, solution providers, internet companies, and even telecom operators. As of 2020, there are nearly 1,500 companies in China's LoRaWAN industry. How amazing that is. Now, if you look across all of products and companies in China's LoRaWAN industry, you will agree with me that it is right on a bright and promising road. With revenues estimated at 6.2 billion in 2020, the market is projected to reach at 36 billion by 2023. With the development of global LoRaWAN industry, so as all companies in China, for the vast majority of the companies in this area, industrialization and standardization are what they are heading to, through the way that enterprises lead the demand and provide suggestions to customers. It is conducive to the standardization of IoT-related products. Although the customized solution has market prospects, it is relatively a niche market. But it doesn't mean that homogenization will gain the way, because companies have gradually realized what suits them best and where their service and products will shine brightly. By working with expertise and powerful R&D teams, many companies have focused more on specific areas, depending on what they are good at. The entire industry chain will next precipitate companies with high professionalism and in-depth understanding of industry applications in the shortest possible time. Meanwhile, vendors have evolved from product providers to solution providers. For example, services packages in the form of product portfolios are more preferred by both companies and consumers, encouraging a real landing of LoRaWAN. Right, as Donna mentioned, the LoRaWAN is very suitable for agriculture in particular. And now I'm gonna introduce you the smart irrigation case landed in Shandong province and Shanxi province of China, which is a great example of the power of LoRaWAN. Hopefully you can start get an idea of what LoRaWAN and smart agriculture feel like. As you know, traditional watering has noticeable limits. For example, only a few experienced farmers could irrigate properly in accordance with what trees need based on either the size of weather or status of soil ground. And it is too late to adjust irrigation procedures when the crops started to show bad appearance. Yet the majority of farmers, around 80% of them, irrigate their trees traditionally rather than with scientific-based information. This causes water waste and affects the quality and quantity of the fruits, as well as reduce profitability, of course. So one of Milesite's partners started their smart irrigation project, where over 3,000 units will be deployed in the US once they got encouraging results from experiments conducted in both China and Israel. We've heard that the results are satisfying enough to push forward the project so far, and some of these are already deployed on US. Alright, let's take a look on China's case. There are around 100 units deployed on fruit plantation located in Shandong province and Shanxi province of China. It is designed for cherry trees, to be specific. By forming a seamless procedure with Milesite UC502 controller enabled by LoRaWAN, gateway and cloud platform, the stem water potential sensor-based precision irrigation system provides a solution that combines accuracy, ease of use, and affordability. The installation way of SWP is a good move. Embedding sensors in the trunk provides direct contact with water tissues for accurate and continuous water status measurements. The status of cherry trees now can be accurately and timely reported. The data will go through all the way from gateways to cloud platform safe and sound. Then farmers can check the status of cherry trees right on a cloud platform anytime, anywhere. The cloud platform brings together all the notifications on devices, organizes them, and highlights the important stuff. Farmers can quickly see priority items or just get a general recap of the day. Now, they can adjust irrigation easily by getting Milesite UC502 controller on or off through cloud platform, and all the cherry trees are under good hands right away. See, in one go, even those basic irrigation becomes a smarter one. The results were truly great. Overall, the solutions noticeably increased cherry production around 5 to 30%, as well as the quality, which brings a higher income. Also, it helps to decrease the water consumption around 5% to 10% by avoiding overwatering. And with a golden irrigation circle like that, it is no surprise that vast of cherry trees are getting healthier and better. Alright, this is just a tip of the iceberg of LoRaWAN applications in agriculture, and we believe there are more to find out. Thank you.
Thanks, Jane, for that incredible presentation, and thank you, Milesite, for being a part of the LoRa Alliance. So I'd like to just end on a couple slides, and one is this, and this is very important. If you really want to know in China what is the latest news on LoRaWAN, the greatest news in technology, what is the progress, and get educated, learn more about use cases and collaborations, the very best way for you to find that information out is to follow LoRa Alliance at our LinkedIn, and the link is below. You will get daily news and the hottest tips and education about LoRaWAN. So I highly recommend that you follow the LoRa Alliance for great information. And last but not least, I want to invite everybody here. We have a LoRaWAN World Expo in Paris, March 29th and 30th in 2022. This is going to be the largest LoRaWAN gathering expo that we have ever had. We anticipate thousands and thousands of attendees. We have some incredible keynotes, demonstrations, booths, education. It'll be very exciting. The brightest minds will be on stage, sharing information, sharing how to drive your business, sharing tips and tricks about LoRaWAN. So I encourage everybody to attend. It will be the event of 2022. With that, thank you very much and have a great webinar.